morning, Pilot teachers and students. Good morning, class.
Good morning, sir.
All right, thank you. You may sit down. Okay. In the past lessons, we have gone through looking at chemistry, probably giving you some idea on what we will be studying now. Okay. Radioactivity, from our definitions, is the slow breaking down of the nucleus, giving out some form of radiation. So it was in the 1800s, that is in 1896, when Becquerel first discovered radioactivity. And how did he discover that? All right, so simply he has to put uranium salt into a photographic plate, and then what he discovered, that there was some form of radiation being coated on that film. So after the discovery of this radioactivity, Marie and Pierre Curie also discovered radioactivity from some of these radioactive elements, and that include radium and polonium. So in this lesson, we'll be going through and then looking at the different types of radioactive decay, and probably some of this decay have been mentioned to you. So we'll have a look at what happens, especially when the nucleus of an atom goes through this type of decays. Okay, there are three types. Okay, the alpha, beta decay, and also the gamma decay. So looking at an atom, you'll find that especially in the nucleus, the proton and the neutrons are unstable because there is unequal numbers of protons and neutrons. That is why a neutron must change into a proton. Okay, when this happens, you find that there is a change in either the atomic mass, or it can be a change in the atomic number. So firstly, we'll go through, I'll give you the three types of decay and explaining each one of these, and then after that I will give you the activity question based on these types of radioactive decay. All right, here is the first information. Okay, you can go through the pilot students. Please take out your exercise book and start copying these notes. Okay, from that theories of an atom, you'll find that the alpha, beta, and gamma are emitted by nuclei or radioactive atoms. Okay, the nuclei of these radioactive atoms will be unstable in a sense that the number of protons and neutrons are not equal. Okay, sometimes you'll find that you have greater number of protons in the nucleus. So for that, it has to go through some kind of decay emitting this radiation. finish. Just copy this information here. This one, omit this, okay? Only this. Right, looking at this alpha, you find that especially when it goes through this type of decay, right, there is a parent nucleate. So in this alpha decay, the atomic number will be, okay, minus by 2, meaning that goes down by 2, and then the mass number will go by 4. And then you have this decay, which is almost similar to a helium ion. So that is the parent nuclei, and you have the daughter nuclei. Okay, that is the first type of decay. I'll give you the second. Okay, by now you should have finished copying that information on alpha decay. Okay, we will now move on to the second type of decay, that is the beta. All right, for this you find that the neutron has changed into a proton emitting this beta radiation. Okay, when the nucleus of an element X emits a particle in the form of negative electron, its atomic number will increase by 1. Its mass number is unchanged. Okay, I'll give you that in the next equation. So quickly go through and then have this information down. Thank you. our students quickly. Here is the additional information on beta decay. I'll quickly go through and then explain each one of these. All right, as from the information that you copied earlier, you find that the represented by the following equation. You have a parent, and when it goes through that, you have Z plus one. That is, the atomic number has to increase by one, and plus this particle is emitted. Right, there is also a form of beta decay which is short-lived. Right, for this information, probably you can go through and read through, but it was an Italian scientist, Enrico Fermi. Okay, what he has to find from this is that the equation does not balance out, meaning that the conservation, it does not follow the law of conservation of mass, meaning that mass after the reaction must be equal to the mass before the reaction. So when he was going through that experiment, he found out that there was only a small portion of that mass which was lost. So he has to come up with a name to give it. That is what is known as, okay. So when it goes through that decay, okay, for the first one, that is, then you have A. And this one will not be changed. Z plus one plus A, an antineutrino, something like that. Okay. So for that you have this one, which is known as an electron. But there is also a form of beta decay which can be short-lived. Okay, and that is. In that case, it will form what is known as a neutrino. So in here, you will have Z, which is equals to Y, and then Z minus 1 plus A. Okay, something like this, V. So in this case, a positive electron is emitted. So they call this one as a positron, okay? So quickly go through and then just have these two equations. I'm explaining what happened from this. So those are the main equations that you can copy from this. For the first one, okay, that is up here, an electron, and then you have a positive electron for this second equation. It finished. Okay, we'll now go into looking at the last form of decay, and then I'll give you some activity questions to solve. All right, here is the last. Okay, as a result of this alpha or beta decay, the nucleus is now in an excited state, and that means it has to have a lot of energy. And this energy is given in a form of gamma radiation. So quickly go through, I'll give you the equation after this. Finish. Okay, this energy is given in a form, or it given up in a form of emission of gamma ray. Okay, if you have finished, I will now go through giving you the equation. Okay, here is the equation. Okay, for this you'll find that nothing changes in the mass number and also the proton. You only have the equation as it is, only a ray or gamma radiation is given. Of Okay, after you finish this, I will give you a few activity questions to solve, and then we'll quickly have a look at that in a few minutes. All right, here are the questions. They have six questions that you can do now. All right, for that equation, you find that it's quite incomplete. So you're just writing that and then fill in those missing spaces. Right in here, you have cobalt 60. And then when it has to go through each one of these, right, look at this and then you write the what will go in here. Okay, so that is number one, or A. Just choose. Okay, you go to number one. All right. You will do 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll give you this number one. Okay, one. Let me see who's gonna do. Okay. 5 and 6. 5 and 6, okay? Finish. Okay, this one, that is cobalt 60. Be a similar symbol here, CO. All right. We move on to question. Here you have polonium 218 and then bismuth 214, and then you have carbon 14, selenium and radium. So quickly go through each one of these, copy, and then you complete. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Alright, for the first one, you find that the polonium has gone through a type of decay in which you will write here. And then you find that there is a change in the atomic number and the atomic mass. So the next element in which this nuclei will decay to is the lead. So in here it is 214. So look at this and then you write down in here what kind of decay it has gone through. Okay, that is for the first. Second, you have this. So what do you think will appear in here. And third, you have carbon 14, which will decay to form an element. What do you think will appear in here? And this one is selenium. So probably if you have your periodic table, we can help you to consult what element that decay will form. Always have in mind that the atomic number is the identifying quantity of an element. You cannot change that. When it is 6, you cannot simply say it is nitrogen, because nitrogen will always have 7. You're ready for your answers. I will ask you to go and then write yours. Wait, let me see where you got that. 40. And then you have... In here, what is it? 16. Okay, so you have different isotopic decays. Okay, isotope of this copper has been used. 59 is another one. You have 16. Okay, so the next would be changes into what is the equation that you wrote? About 60.27, and then what is this? 4 manganese, 27 minus 2 would be 27 minus 2 would be 25. Finish copying the last 5 questions. Does not change. So I've given you an equation in which copper stays the same. So what do you think will be appearing in here? Okay. You see, when you hold through copper 20, 50, 60, 60, and that is 27. And here this copper same 60 and that is 27. So that means this type of decay was given, nothing changes in the either the mass or the proton number. Okay. Let's see. For B or C? No, it's not a positron, it's a negative electron. Okay. We'll now have the answers to each one of those questions. Okay, the first person will be asked to go in and explain your answer. After that, we'll have the second answer, and then so on, right down to question number six. So number one would be Samuel. You can go up to the board and then show your, or write your answers down quickly. Okay. Here, use this.
What number will I be doing?
I told this guy is plus this two. Not him. Okay, next. Can you explain your one of the kid ready. There, you explain. You're not sure about the explanation. All right. Come. Okay, next. Let me see, sorry. 84, where is 84? since we have Poland mission. Yeah.
That's
okay. Poland is
2.
Poland is 84, is it? No. It should be 82. Where is 82? No, that's correct. Okay, one of you, get ready.
During beta decay, a neutron changes into a proton and then electron. The proton remains in the nucleus while electron is shot out, thus increases into, we just add one, as carbon 14 changes into nitrogen.
Okay. What do you mean? Radium. So radium. You don't want to. You will just write the. Okay, you can go and write your answers only. Okay, quickly go through and then looking at these answers. The first one is looking at this. Okay, this one is set correct?
Yes.
Okay, yes. Since it is going through, nothing changes in the atomic mass or the atomic number because it is going through this gamma decay. That is correct. Okay, for this we have polonium, which is 218, and then it goes through this because it changes only in this, so we know that this one will be okay, alpha decay, helium. So it is 214, and then that is 82. That is correct. Okay, for C will be lead to 4, and then when it goes through, that decay will have something like that. So this one will be this one will be 82. So in here you have 214 is smooth. Okay. And then we have carbon 14, which is having this. When it goes through that decay, the next will be nitrogen. Okay, so you have 14. Okay, that is correct. For this will be 33, and then in here you have, okay, supposed to be 75. Okay, nothing changes. Okay, it starts from this. Okay. Okay, in that is 76. Anyway, it was supposed to be, okay, 75. So in here, you have this one as co-introduced beta decay, and then you have this one changes to 34. And last one, you can see that that is radium, that is 88, and then when it goes through that, changes by 4 in here, and that is 2. So that'll be a decay. All right, so that is basically the answers to what we gone through, looking at the different types of decay, right? Firstly, because the nucleus is unstable, it has to lose or emit this in a form of alpha beta radiation. But then when these two are emitted, you find that it is also in an excited state. And that means it has to have plenty of energy. And this is now given in a form of gamma radiation. So for the first type of radiation, which is for alpha, you'll find that it changes by 2. Okay, minus 4 from the atomic mass, and also 2 will be minus from the atomic number. And then for beta decay, you find that there will be an increase in the atomic number. And the last one, there won't be any decay, or that's a change in the atomic mass or the mass numbers. So that brings us to the end of the lesson on different types of decay. Okay, when you are given equations like that, you can only check to see with the identifying quantity of an element, is the proton number or the atomic number. Okay, from that you can identify. But the others, the mass number can change. Okay, it depends on the number of isotopes that this element or nuclei has. Right, so in our next lesson, we'll be looking at the decay series. Right. For the pilot students, I will ask you to come with graph papers if you have any, and also a periodic table to help you plot out the graph on different types of decay and decay series. Right. So our keyword for today will be radioactive decay. Good morning, pilot teachers and students. Good morning, class.
Good morning, Mr. Simon.
All right, thank you. You may sit down.